Yeah, there's a good number. I don't know what was going on, like, yesterday, for example. Since I didn't see a lot of people at AB's stream, but yeah. But I'm not sure what to think about the timing, since that was pretty much the, time when the surprise kitten situation happened with AB, but also what's going on with the noise gates. Because it kind of looks like it's, alright. It looked like it was a bit, lower than usual. But now apparently it's back normal. Well, I've been having a bit of sleep troubles as well. Since this week was pretty much my week off, I thought it would be okay for me to, like, pretty much oversleep for the beginning of it. But then everything got pretty much, everything got so that I couldn't easily fix my schedule again. And today what happened was basically I was gonna try to go to bed fairly early yesterday, but that didn't work, so I ended up staying until like, until like 1, 2 p.m. basically today, like 4 hours ago, and I realized that I probably wasn't gonna be able to stay up like long enough to be able to stream like this, so I pretty much took a nap about 4 hours, so I really hope that I get sleepy again in a few hours, but but at least I don't feel too sleepy right now. But anyway, let me see if I can get this running. It looks like I will be able to get this running. Because this is actually one of the games that that I was trying to run. I was testing pretty much. Pretty much since I started the streams that, or my streams. Because I thought I would be playing it eventually. And it looks like it's running fine right now, but let me see if I can change. I don't think I can, but no, I can't. I thought maybe I could change the aspect ratio, but no. You know what? Hang on a minute. Maybe I can do this from the launcher, which is how I was able to get it in a window. So let me try that out real quick, but yes, this is... So some people may recognize this game. Yes, it worked correctly. Thank you for asking, Windows, but now's not the time. Now let's see. Do I want Mafia? No, no, no. I want setup or... Oh, setup, there we go. Alright, yeah, it does have resolution options. So which of these is 4x3? Is it this one? Is it that one? I think it might be that one. Doesn't look like it that, like it is that one though. Since it doesn't seem. Four by three, hang on. And for some reason, hang on. Pretty sure I can figure this out. What was the translation for this? Okay. Oh, I'm pretty sure this is the one I want. Let me test it. Yep, there we go. I'm totally a smart person, guys. But now I need to recapture this because I did change the new size of this, but here we go. Yes, this is a game from Europe. Also, now we get to watch this intro because it didn't skip for some reason. I'm not sure why you would want this tattooed on your arm, but... Well, I guess this is from an alternate world in which a software company is big enough where you would want to do that. But yes, this is, in fact... a game by the name of Mafia. And, actually I forget if I pick intro. Oh, it actually does start you off at the prologue. Well, alright then, let's get right on in. But yeah, very cool, this game is actually a Czech production. But it's quite a memorable one. It's totally that fast. Yes, this is, you know, this was released for, the PC several years ago, but it's totally one of those games where even though it's offline, you have to click on something and then wait for, several hours to be able to click on it again, and that's how you make progress. As we will soon learn. But yeah, this game has some pretty good music, not just this song, and, but also some of the conflict themes, and, well, some of the other situational themes, and pretty much just the music for roaming around, as we will soon learn. That's pretty much the reason why I titled the stream what it's currently titled. Also, by the way, this is set in a fictional city, as the name's title kind of indicates, called Lost Heaven. But it's supposed to evoke the general atmosphere of a specific city as well. See if you can figure out what it is. Sure, I was playing Saints Row 3 and doing that last night, that we're just seeing the camera do. And that also happens to be part of the reason why I chose this game. It was pretty much a toss-up between what to do next. It was Elvis or, well, something else that I'll probably do in the near future as well. But I've pretty much been on, sort of sandbox game, or at least to an extent. I guess roll of sorts lately. I'm not sure whether you can tell yet. But here's our protagonist. And I'm sure we'll learn his name again in just a few moments, since his first actual interaction with other characters should be about to begin. So yes, it's totally Indigo Prophecy. you know, when David Cage made games about mafiosos in the 30s.
Detective Norman, can I join you?
Also, we get a framing device.
Sorry for the delay, but I didn't want anybody seeing me, if you know what I mean.
What can I get you, sir?
Just a coffee.
Coming right up.
It's not my habit to sit with people like you.
Got a business proposition for you, Detective.
I ain't no businessman. And even if I were, I wouldn't be doing business with the likes of you.
I don't usually do business with your kind either. But this is a bit of a strange deal. Good for you and your superiors, and good for me. It concerns a certain kind of trade.
Trade?
Well, let's just say that I hold a high position in a not-so-legal organization. It's just the kind of organization people such as yourself would like to know a lot about. And I, on the other hand, for certain reasons, don't want...
Your coffee, sir.
Thanks. I have my own personal reasons why I don't want to be associated with this organization. It ain't too easy to leave this kind of business, if you know what I mean.
I think I know where you're coming from. You'll get a bullet in your head if you don't disappear quickly, right?
That's not the only reason. Got any kids, Detective? I've got a wife and daughter. I don't want them to have any problems because of me.
Yeah, well, I ain't just gonna hand out protection to any wop crook. You should have thought about them kids before, cause I...
Sure, sure. Listen, I don't want something for nothing. So here's the deal. Does the name Salieri mean anything to you?
Salieri? It damn well does. You got something to come with him?
You could say that. I've worked for him for several years. Now he wants to rub me out. If you protect my family and me, I'll tell you everything. Names, dates, accounts, everything. Enough to put him away for life.
I ain't Santa Claus. If I go to the chief with this, I need to know everything you know. And I have to be sure you'll testify in court.
Sure. If you ain't in a hurry, I'll tell you my whole story. And all the deals I worked on over the years.
Okay. I've got time, and I'm listening.
So that was the intro. I thought for a moment that it would apparently just carry over into the actual game, but no, apparently we need to actually do this manually. But luckily the game does give you this list of 12 playable scenarios, pretty much, and this should be the very beginning, so let's dive right in. I don't think it should be, I don't know if it's going to replay the bar scene, but I don't think it should. Or it would probably be showing a loading screen for that right now. Nope. So let's see why apparently Mozart's rival is running mafioso gangs in the 30s.
I was glad to be working. It was a bad time and some other people were worse off than me. It was that very taxi that drew Salieri's people to me in the first place.
Oh no.
One day I was on my break and I was just hanging out. Suddenly I heard a tremendous crash.
Sam! They got me! Damn it!
Climb up and move. There's a taxi. We'll be okay.
It was clear to me that these guys had to get out of there fast, so I thought it was best to cooperate, rather than ending up with a hole in my head.
Move it. Come on.
Where to?
Anywhere! Fast! Hope you're damn fast! faster than Sam here was.
I burned rubber out of there like a bat out of hell. It didn't matter where, just away from those gentlemen who were chasing my new customers.
Now listen carefully. You gotta shoot these clowns behind us. If you don't do it, then we're done for. That includes you. Step by, kid.
So it would essentially be in our best interest to listen to an old Joe Pesci right now.
Can't you go any faster?
Nuggets.
Can't you go any faster?
Don't I have the feeling the,
Boy, I'm a bag full of holes or what?
My taxi!
Oh, boy.
Die!
The controls aren't being very corrupt, cooperative right now.
Shoot him, Sam!
Like that?
Oh, boy. Hang on. Oh, goodness. Okay, wait just a moment. No, not that. This. Oh, the car controls. Well, it seems like it should be fine. I guess the auto gear, or the manual gear, might be on,
now listen carefully. You gotta shake these clowns
behind. The automatic gearing is on, so I'm not sure what is going on here.
Step on it, kid.
I guess just 30 cars is the answer.
Something pushing it.
Since you have kind of the atmosphere of this as well, since this is the 30s, the cars aren't exactly great, but I see that just made the other guy crash into the trolley back there, so... Hell, this might actually go better for once.
We're finished! Move it if you want to save your own ass!
Also, I don't really see him on the radar blip anymore, so I might actually have done it this time.
Great!
Yep,
we made it! Good work, brother. Now take us to Salieri's bar. I'll show you the way.
So sure enough, now that we've used our own wily wit to get rid of the pursuers, apparently. It's time to go to... whoops. To Salieri's bar, as the gangster whom we somehow know is named Paulie has just helpfully told us. Also, I'm pretty sure that pressing tabs should be able to, bring up a minimap of some sort. I'm not sure why that's not happening right now. Maybe I'm pressing the wrong button? Yes, I am. There we go. So yeah, we get this handy map of town that we can bring up pretty much whenever we're driving around. Oh boy. Also, notice how you get the, three bars of sorts in the bottom left, which pretty much denote the health of whoever's with you right now. The red one being, of course, your own health, and the blue ones being the health of your allies. Looks like we're doing fairly well for ourselves, at least, but small prices will, in fact, still chip away at it, so. So that can be a way to kind of dumbly finish yourself off if you manage to have low health. As I came to learn many times while playing this. Also, I have no way they can just stay up in this altar area. Well, more like middle area, but...
taking a bit long, ain't it?
Yeah, I also noticed that we appear to have a 10, the time limit in the upper right. But hey, we're getting there. But yeah, since this is a 30s car going up the bridge, it's not an easy task, or going up any slopes, for that matter. Usually brings us down in speed unless we're going particularly fast, which we kind of are right now. Well, I don't know what to think of the fact that a car that goes so slowly can skid so easily. But all we're gonna do is go through a tunnel and we'll go to Western Island, where apparently Little Italy is, and that's where the bar is. So let's go ahead and get up with this. While trying not to crash horribly into things. Which would probably be counterproductive. Oh yeah, here we go. This is what happens if you were trying to go up a slope. I know you're not going very fast, it just slows way down. As well it should, I suppose. And then you just drive straight through, apparently, a wooden telephone booth. Also, I think I'm gonna need a low since I didn't participate in this hangout. What the bar is right there, it's the
by chance.
Salieri bar. See if I'm lost as we're pulling up in front of it.
Finally, we're home.
Well, time for,
Then we'll get you a little something from Mr. Salieri.
Another intense cutscene.
Oops. Thanks for your help.
With this thrill-building music. Well, I wonder how Tommy can be so calm and then get worried all of a sudden. But yeah, they do have something for us after all. Got a clip into our chest to get it.
Mr. Salieri would like to thank you as well as myself and Pauly. It's compensation for the damage to your car and your services. It should be enough.
Yes, of course. Thanks. Give my regards to Mr. Salieri.
Mr. Salieri wants you to know that he is very grateful to you. If you ever need anything, you can come back and ask for help, because Mr. Salieri doesn't forget about friends who have helped him out. If you're interested, maybe we could find a job for you here. And it would pay well. We always have positions for guys as good as you.
Okay, okay. I'll think about it. Thanks, really thanks. I'd better go to fix the car and so on.
All right, I understand. Just think about it. And I hope it's clear that this matter is only between ourselves. You take care, kid.
And while this little scene plays out, we get to hear Salieri's theme for the first time. But we don't get to meet him just yet.
When I opened the envelope, I almost had a heart attack. There was more than it would cost to do the repairs. But I didn't for a minute think about their offer. I didn't want to join some criminals, even if they had all the money in the world. It's better to be poor and alive than rich in debt, right? I was going to get my cab repaired and try to forget it all as soon as possible. As my mother always said, you can never predict what God has in store for you.
And funny he should say that, because... well, we'll see a bit of, something else
Hey, could you take me to the church downtown, please?
Okay.
Relating to that scene before too long, but now we get back into the daily run of things as Tommy is, in fact, a regular cab driver. And now he needs to drive people around. Both Sodges is leaving, and also this game does have a feature. Or you can just press F5 and it turns on a speed limiter, which pretty much means that you cannot get busted by the cops for going over the speed limit, which is something like 60, I'm guessing miles per hour, it might be kilometers per hour. But there aren't really any cops around right now, so it shouldn't matter if, you know, luckily the cops do show up in the radar and all. But right now I need to wait for the bridge to be low again. Well, I can see that there's apparently a cop on the other side of the bridge, so it will be in our best interest not to go over the speed limit right now. But now they're gone, so we can go right ahead. Oop, probably should have turned there. Oh well. Also, which area of town you might notice as it's so indistinct. Ambient soundtrack, I suppose. But I believe the parts we will be in the most will be the central island area, which has the song Vale Vale and Little Lily, which has a song Cavalry. Both of them are Django Reinhardt songs, which is why I named the stream, or I named it. So let's
okay,
see.
Okay, drop me off here at the steps.
Well, they made it.
Thanks, here's the fare.
And apparently got money from it, even though there's not an actual warning mechanic in this game.
Are you taken? I need to go to the hospital. You are.
No problem.
Newark, which is apparently up there. But now we're still entirely certain where we are, I guess, New England area? But this city, Lost Heaven, is actually an amalgamation, I suppose, of various big cities from that area. Even though I think Newark is a Jersey thing, if I recall correctly. During this initial portion, you have to be kind of careful since it's not just the cops that you're trying to avoid. Since you are actually driving someone around, if you do something reckless, they will pretty much get mad at you and you will be sent back to a checkpoint. And by something reckless, I pretty much mean running someone over. You can bump into someone else. Another car that is without too many trouble. Too many problems, and it doesn't say anything if you, like, go too fast, or, keep running red lights, like I'm pretty sure I'm doing. But if you run someone over, that one has a problem. Also, if I recall, you can press horn with K, but you're gonna have to take your, actually, I don't think the mouse even does anything in this, in the driving section, so you can just use the arrow keys pretty much.
Here it is. You drop me off in front of the entrance.
Is that good enough? Yeah, apparently it is.
Thanks. Here's the fare.
I think it was Mickey, but I've never seen that version. I've heard things. Apparently it wasn't very good.
I'm lucky you're here. I need to get to the theater on Central Island. Take the Giuliano Bridge so that we can get there quickly.
Whatever you want.
Watch out, the purpose of this section isn't just to... pad out the intro section. But it's actually supposed to get you to familiarize yourself to some extent with this area of the map, at least. But since this is a game of a GTA's persuation, we will in fact be driving around quite a lot. Actually do have some speed build helping though. It's not really that much. Though we don't slow down as egregiously when we're going up the slopes. I think that might have been me. I'm pretty sure I played this during a series of tests I made to see how these games would run while streaming. But that was pretty much way back when I was back on Twitch.
Here's the money. Goodbye.
Good day. Could you take me to Hoboken, Pompeii Bar?
Sure thing. Get in.
But if I recall correctly, this should be the last guy for now. But had to go back out to the east part, apparently, which means we had to go over the bridge again. I did play Mafia 2 and I did like it as well, but... I feel like I should see... does it end that abruptly? Very cool, it's more or less the... maybe not the same length as this, but... I can actually recall it going on for a little bit longer. Ah, but then it just ends. Yeah, but this is true, actually. This, I guess climax mission of that game doesn't really have a... have the same sort of weight that the climax mission of this game does. But it kind of fits, you know, with the overall theme of, that game, which kind of contrasts to some extent with the one of this one, which is, very much this game is supposed to be a more, slightly romanticized narrative to an extent. At least until the end, spoiler alert. But the second game, Mafia 2, is actually supposed to be pretty much all about how horrible a life of crime can be all throughout. So I don't know, it's, I would say that way, yeah, it was actually kind of fitting in that regard. But anyway, we're almost to place where we will drop this guy off.
I'm supposed to walk from here? Pull into the entrance, please.
Alright. I didn't realize it was across the street. Excuse me, princess. I thought. But then I couldn't actually tell where I was going. Is that the place? Yep, apparently it is.
Keep the change.
Well, I thought it was only four guys, but no, apparently there's more.
I need to get to the department store car lot in Little Italy. Can you take me there?
No problem. Get in.
Oh, here we go. Pretty sure this is the last guy.
Go across the Giuliano Bridge and then through the tunnel. It's the shortest way.
Yep, we'll be using that route many times. We go from the eastern part of the maps back to Little Italy, which is where Salieri's bar is. Which is pretty much going to become the hub of the game. Now apparently it's only been about 10 minutes of this. And I didn't really feel that long when I did this, even the first time I did.
I said over the Giuliano Bridge. Don't you know which one that is?
I can't remember if I was in like middle school or high school when I played this for the first time. I think it was high school. I actually don't remember how I first heard about this, but I remember that it was around the time that I discovered it that I pretty much also discovered Cherry Doom's Let's Play of the game, which I thought was pretty funny. But I honestly don't know how much I can talk about that. I don't know how readily available that would be right now, since even back then I couldn't really find a lovely part of that. I probably shouldn't be getting gas first. Well, there aren't any cops around, so you know. But, well, thankfully the game has checkpoints to helpfully tell you where you're supposed to go. To get where you're going quickly from this spot. Did I do Max Payne? No, I did not actually. I haven't even, I think I played a little bit of that game on my own, but I didn't actually get anywhere near finishing it. I don't even know if I finished the first stage of that. But no, I haven't done that for the streams, but not at any point. Actually, it might have been Max Payne 2 that I'm thinking of. I don't even know if I ever played the first one. But we're nearly there. Until 1976. You know, Doctor Who, the Deadly Assassin, that's when The Matrix was new. But no one remembers that. For some reason. Except, you know, people like me who watch Doctor Who, because we're losers there. And funny to see that right now, because I actually have one of my favorite, if not my favorite, pretty much all time Doctor Who stories queued up for tonight for after this, or at least the first half of it. So here we go.
This should cover it. Keep the chain.
Pretty sure that's the last guy we're gonna have to run
for. I need a coffee break.
And we'll go on coffee break, which. Which propitiates the next part of the plot.
In the car while I was waiting to see if I could get another customer. I noticed I wasn't far from Salieri's bar.
You little rat.
Mr. Morello's pretty angry with you. We're gonna have to teach you a little lesson so you remember that it ain't right.
Those bastards remembered the license plate of my car and took it on themselves to hunt me down.
Yeah, I guess remembering
his face a little.
Remembering his face have been a little bit more difficult, but. But now we need to make our getaway.
It's clear to me that I had to get out of there fast. I couldn't handle that animal on my own. I said to myself that now was probably the right moment for Mr. Salieri to show his gratitude. Salieri's bar was just down the street, and the sight of it was certainly a lot nicer than a baseball bat to my head.
Also, apparently, every time we get hit, we lose 20 health, so... Tell you, probably not, Oh, wait, never mind. It's apparently determined differently each time, but... Yeah, right now, we pretty much gotta keep running without... dying. Which can be kind of difficult when stuff like that happens, and when you got people who want to kill you after you. Also, you get a bit of a gag here. That guy's waiting for someone in the passageway. Is this the way, or premise? I think it's this way. There it is. I thought, but then it wasn't. I think I might be dead now. Or we might have pulled a quick save there. Ah, there we go. So hang on a minute. Oh wait, what are you doing screen? Why are you letting the mouse go off the screen for some reason? And she said to meet him at 3 in the passageway. So I think someone's confused, but they're gonna be even more confused when they get someone shooting at someone else going right by them. But we made it to the bar. Well, I don't know why they would just wander right in. Alright. Apparently that's taken care of.
Salieri's boy saved my skin that time, but I certainly wasn't in a good situation. I had paid off my debts for the car repairs, but my boss didn't want to employ anyone who's in the mob. It just wasn't good business. When I saw the fancy getup of Salieri's boys, I thought that it can't be too bad to work for him. Besides, I had nothing to lose. Morello was out to get me, so driving a cab wasn't the best job. Plus, the prospect of Salieri's dough wasn't so terrible. So like I always say, better to die young and loaded.
Yeah, like he always says, even though it pretty much completely contradicts what he said in the last scene, where he talked about that.
Well, it looks like Morello is really trying to make me mad. But I'm a reasonable person. What do they call you, son?
Thomas Angelo.
I've decided to give you a shot, Tommy. I like new faces. We're one big family here. You already know Paulie and Sam? Frank here is my right hand and looks after the legal side of our business.
Our business.
Behind the bar is Luigi. This business ain't easy to swallow. But Luigi's a wonderful cook. Paul will introduce you to Vincenzo and Ralph. There are a lot of us. But those should be enough for now. Now listen, and listen good. We have some rules around here. Don't cross paths with the cops. They're on our payroll, so they'll leave you alone. But if you go too far, they'll all come after you. Money or no money. If they ever pick you up, say nothing, and I will take care of you. I show my gratitude to those people that helped me, and there aren't many left to betray me. Capiche?
Yes, Mr. Salieri.
I'm glad. Today I'll give you a chance to get back at those bastards who wrecked your taxi. We'll see what you're made of. Morello has a bar where all his gorillas go. They all have their cars parked behind the fence next to the bar. If you're good, they won't be there tomorrow morning. Paulie'll go with you just in case. Go see Vincenzo for equipment and Ralph for some wheels.
I wouldn't trust him so much. He seemed hesitant. He's just accepting now because he has no choice.
We'll see, Frank. We'll see. I'm more concerned about what Morello's problem is. Does he really want to start a war?
Oh boy.
Vincenzo's the Don's gun expert. They've known each other since they were kids.
Also, that's a gate.
He gets you whatever you want. Tommy guns to cannons. Then he can set you up. I always pay him a visit before a job. Buongiorno, Vincenzo.
Ciao, Pauly.
This here's Tom. Just started up with us.
Pleased to meet means you, Tom. Goodbye,
what
though?
Can I do for the both of you?
We got a job to do. We need something to write off a few cars.
This classic piece of sports equipment should do the job, and if not, I've mixed up a few cocktails. Careful with them, though.
Thanks a lot, Vincenzo.
Bring back the bat. It's my nephew's.
Sure thing.
Oh, boy.
Ralph, I'll introduce you to, is a complete idiot, but he's got a special way with cars. I don't get how such a moron could know anything about anything. But that's the way it goes sometimes.
visit. How you all doing, Paulie?
Hey, Ralphie.
Yeah, I see you're still limping, so we got two cripples working here.
That's right, but I ain't a fool. Ralph, this is Tom. If you bring him a stolen car, Tommy, I'll make it your own, and no one will know the difference. Ralph, Tom and me have a job to do. You're supposed to have some wheels for us?
Right. Here it is. It ain't no hot rod, but it should really do for you.
Thanks, Ralphie. Let's go.
Well, I don't know what might be going on with Clive Sheen default, unfortunately, but... well, I remember that some time ago, pretty much, Twitch did that for me, and... right before our mic stream, and then I pretty much had to try a whole bunch of different things, like giving cash and reinstalling the brush altogether, pretty much. As well as some other stuff that I can't remember right now. But I think I did get it to work eventually. I don't know what the problem might be, but right now we need to execute our first mission as a mafioso by going up against our apparently rival mafiosos. By pretty much driving right across town and wrecking their cars in revenge, but we need to actually drive across town first. Well, thankfully it's not too far. Don't you know, it tastes a bit tomatoey. Tastes a bit gamey, you know, tastes a bit off. That's a very good way to put it, totally. It tastes like atoms. It's kind of like it has a molecular structure, you might say. Well, thanks. Oh god, apparently we lost 3 health from that. Also, I can see that there's a cop right in front of me, so it's probably not a good idea to run up a red light right now. Hence why I'm stopped right now. Thank goodness he didn't see, didn't see us bump into that guy before, though. And we're nearly there, it looks like. And here we are.
Okay, we're here. Don't go through the front. Find another way. Pick out the guy quietly so you don't arouse any attention. If you manage to cause up with the bat, save the fireworks for us. Do some hastings. Take a look. Good luck, buddy. Thanks. I'll be back in a little while.
Also, I don't remember what the car for, or what the key for living the car is. Trying E, but apparently that doesn't work. I'm trying R. Hang on a minute. I can't much believe that I can't actually remember what the key for this is, but no, that's inventory key. Hello. Oh boy. Now I've been trying E and doesn't really seem to be doing that much. Hang on, is it this? Yeah, it's the right mouse button. So it's actually a key, it's actually a button on the mouse. Oh boy. Now you use the right mouse key to drag mouse button to interact with things. Also, there's that guy looking right at the entrance, so let's take care of him. And totally miss, but not that time. Yeah, it's actually supposed to be. I actually forgot about that. So we should have a couple of Molotov cocktails, so let's go right ahead and put them to use. And we don't have any more, so we're just gonna have to do this the old-fashioned way now. Mine turns into a spaceador and prisoner. Oh boy. And that blew up in my face. Kind of. Have I done enough damage to this yet? Because it doesn't. I don't think it's. It's telling me that it has. Have I done enough damage or what? Well, I don't know. It seems to be telling me to. Hello? Oh boy. Thank you. seems to be telling me to leave now. Otherwise, I'll miss people trying to walk into me when I'm clearly trying to move. Okay, we can actually lift this car from the garage. I guess we're supposed to go now. I didn't even get attacked or anything, so mission accomplished. Easy enough. And I think we got a slightly better car for our troubles. I think by far the best car in the game, though, is the old one. There's Silver Fletcher, but here's what happens when the cops see you doing something bad.
Driver, broken the lock. I'll have to find him.
Okay, officer. Here's the deal.
But when they just find you like this, you can pretty much do this, and
I hope it won't happen again.
And they forget about this, and you know, money isn't actually a factor in this game, so you can just do this whenever you want. So you know that the lesson to be learned from this is avoid the cops, clearly. Or don't get caught, either way. Also, I'm kind of disappointed that apparently the music isn't playing during this time of day. Apparently, I somehow didn't get hurt from that, but I think my car took away from that. But it's not actually my car anyway, so you know what bad things actually happened. I'm not sure what I should be driving with my one hand on the mouse at all. It seems you can't really do anything with the mouse while you're driving, or at least not in this section. Well, you kind of need to devote your right hand, I think, to either the mouse or this. Also, where am I going? Alright, we need to pretty much every time, just leave the car whenever and or wherever. And you walk into the back door here.
So we're back, boss.
Wonderful. Take a seat. It all went well?
Sure, boss, he's a natural. Before they could say cannolis, they were wheelless. And before they could recover, we were gone. Morello is probably pretty pissed right now.
Really? I'm glad to hear it.
He's one tough customer.
In that case, welcome to the family, Tommy. You've passed the first
test. It's an honor, sir.
And now we've got a new member.
I'd like to take him into the outfit, boss. You can see he ain't scared, and he's done real good.
You didn't disappoint me, Tommy. Now, let's drink.
Thanks.
And there we go. We actually do get the new cars, after all. And we need to press enter for this. And now for the actual first challenge of the game, I believe.
Today we're gonna visit a few places to collect some protection money. Two restaurants and a motel outside of town. Bill at the motel was late last time because he had a few problems. So today, he'll pay a little more.
You may have heard about how criminals can prey on businesses using various threats. That certainly isn't the case with us. People who pay us receive services, which the police certainly can't provide them with. Last month, for example, Sam and Paulie here solved a serious problem with violence in a delightful restaurant. The owner is now satisfied that nothing of that sort will happen there again.
You'll do the driving. Paulie and Sam will do the collecting. It'll be routine. Tell Ralph to give you a car, and you can go.
Okay, boss.
Well, you and I'll have a drink. What do you say, Frank?
Well, you know, this actually does take place in the same, sort of universe.
Sorry, Tom, I don't got enough time right now.
Yeah, pretty much. You old criminals, what are you talking about? Also, I'm sure we can punch people in this, this restaurant. And we don't get any repercussions for doing so, so, you know, fun stuff. But it's not really if we try to attack Luigi, though, we do get wrecked, though. But yeah, there is a pretty much one direct connection between this game and Mafia 2. But that's pretty much not revealed until much, much later on.
I won't keep you now, Tom.
We'll go for a beer sometime.
But I'm pretty sure the first thing we're supposed to do here is go and, and...
Hey, Vincenzo. I need some kind of gun.
Hey, Tom, I think this'll do the trick.
Champion, you know, there's also the slight time window difference.
It should work. I wasn't planning on using it anyway. Thanks.
Since this is during the 30s and early 40s, and Mafia 2 is during the mid 40s and 50s, pretty much. Also, we get ourselves a gun, so, you know, stuff. And now, let's see if we need to talk to this guy for a car.
Hey, Ralphie. Me and the boys have got a job to do, and I need some wheels.
Hey, I sorted out what you brought me last time. It has a good motor, Tom. It has almost 60 horsepower and goes a good 75 miles per hour. He has four speeds and brake servos. Simply beautiful. Also, I had a look at how you could best steal one.
I used to drive one when I was a cabbie, so I know how to get into one, Ralphie.
Well, then I got another little number. It has about 40 horsepower and goes at almost 60 miles an hour.
Oh, boy.
Ain't nothing swanky, but it's a good enough drive. You get into it easy. You just take this little baby and stick it in here. Pry it a little, and when it clicks, you got it.
So yeah, this is pretty much how you steal the cars in this game.
Cake.
Thanks, Ralphie.
Just hold down the button and wait until that bar fills up. And hope that no one sees you while you're trying to get that. And here we go. Now if we actually have any car, we just wait for this guy to get in. And here we go. Out into the actual city.
Okay. First we'll go to a restaurant on Central Island.
Also, that horn not appearing. But let's see. I don't believe there's actually that much we can do in this first part of the mission beyond just wait for stuff to happen. But we'll get to the action before the end of this.
Thank you.
backup should be right here. And now we pretty much just wait and actually get out of the car while we're waiting. And kind of wander around. Should maybe punch out one of these phones. I'll try to. Okay, we actually need to wait a bit. While we're waiting for the water to come back out, apparently it sounds like they're doing. Here we go. Hello. Okay, yeah, not listening. And you know, pretty much, I record all my streams and then upload them, so always check it out later if you want. So where are we going now? Looks like we're going to the looks like we're going to the Eastern Island now. Also for some reason I feel like I'm mumbling today more than I usually do. Like, I cannot enunciate properly. I wonder why that could be. Probably doesn't have anything to do with the fact that I pretty much woke up right before I did this, no sir. Even though I've been doing this for about an hour now. Yeah, I've listened to all of these songs pretty much enough times, like. Also, you can actually, the people actually respond to the horn and this. Why did you do that? Oh well. So you can pretty much make them, get out of the street. They're just honking the horn at them. Which I guess can be handy sometimes, but oh boy. Of course there was a couple right around the corner. Well, you know exactly what to do. Actually, I'm pretty sure we can, there's like just one lone cop on the street, you can just run over here pretty much, and there's no difference. Since there were no witnesses, that were also cops. I actually didn't think of that this time. And since this is, you know, the 30s, they don't have radios or anything. So unless there's likely a telephone booth around, there's no way that anyone could find out. We just ran over him or shot him, but... But I guess we're actually going to be prudent right now, not trying to do that. So yeah, actually, I'm pretty sure, funny you should mention that, that's actually featured in one of the videos where... of the Let's Play I was talking about earlier that Cherry Dude did. I actually show that off at some point. I don't know if I can, I know I have that... Actually, where are we going? Is this a place for, this is, in fact, the place. I don't know if I would be able to easily find that again. I guess I should look into that. But for now, let's just wait for Polly to come back out. I guess I would find a way to, transfer the actual video from my play to the video, but yeah. Yeah, well, good night, listen. And good stuff. And I don't know what I'm saying. Good stuff, good things. Stuff that draws attention away from the fact that I suppose I'm not entirely awake right now to some extent, but maybe it's like that time when I thought I actually had a few drinks and I thought I was drunk, but apparently I actually got like sobered up over the course of the stream. I feel more drunk now than I did then, even though I haven't had anything. But now we actually need to get to our third and final destination, which is this motel on the outskirts of town, in the abyssal regions which have no map, as we will come to learn. Pretty much just keep going north from here. Apparently this might be over yet. There is in fact an airport this way. I will not have to go there at the end of the first act, but that will not be for a while now. No, it said we go off the map now, and I'm pretty much going on our own adventure, actually, if I recall the countryside of this. It's actually fairly vast. I'm not sure just how far you can go, but you can go pretty far. And that will also be showcased through this mission, as we will soon come to learn. But first, let's see if we can actually get to... Oh boy. What's the speed limit out here? It's still 60, but we're on, like, freeway. You would think that the speed limit would be a little bit higher when you're out of the city, but apparently not. There we go. So let's see how things go at the motel. Apparently they sell genuine motor oil, that's certainly not a Texaco knockoff.
Wait for us here, Tom. We'll be back in a bit.
Okay,
let's go.
Oh no. Traco. Never mind. Nope, Traco's definitely not a Texaco knockoff. What are you talking about? So let's go ahead and smoke right next to the gas pumps. Oh yeah, but the boom came from a different direction than expected, I'll bet.
Shit! Bastards! Tommy! I took one! It hurts!
Jesus Christ, Pauly!
Del Salieri, from here on out, this place is ours. Capiche? Don't come back here, you'll end up in worse shape than your friends.
Get Sam! They want to beat some information out of him. Get him out of there!
But I gotta get you to a doctor.
That'll wait. First, get Sam.
Well, indeed, we will first get Sam.
Screw regular routine.
As we deal with this regular routine, with our 18 bullets that we have. Also, there's probably there's a dog back here who will hurt us very much. Even if we manage to get onto the silver platform first. Apparently there's enough room for the dog to hurt us, but no, we actually get in here and run into our first challenge of the game, which is surviving this section. But luckily we can get more guns from ambushing these odd guys who tell us here all the way. But yeah, there's actually quite a few guys waiting to kill us here. So this scene is pretty much the bane of many new players, but let's see, the weapon is fully loaded apparently. Can we reload the weapon? We can, I believe. And we have more 1911 bullets, but I don't know. Maybe the Magnum could be able to use, but before we proceed, I'm sure we want to go here. One of these places. Since there should be a back in our base rooms, which we cannot meet since we're down to half health. So, can we open this door or can we not? Apparently it's not working. We can open this door though. Also we can find the Tommy gun again, that's right. So now Tommy is actually wielding a Tommy gun. Still wondering why this door doesn't work. Place where the thing is, yes, there we go. Yeah, sure, but anyway, I haven't really seen Chimp post in this chat, so I don't know if it's actually here right now. Well, at any rate, let me see chair generally. Do that, why not? I need to actually expand the window though, so I can actually see the make mod button. And even then I can barely see it. There we go. And now I need to make this window smaller so that I can have it the proper size. There we go. And now back to this. Let's see if we can survive. Actually doing quite well so far, but then there comes this room, which kind of a challenge, as we will soon come to learn. Let's see if we can take this guy with the we have three guns, hang on. Yeah, we have three pistols. Oh boy. I don't really understand how you're not hitting that guy, but oh, there we go. Pretty sure there's a guy with like a Tommy gun behind the bar. So good luck to deal with that guy right now. Oh boy, hang on a minute. No, the stream didn't freeze, but something unexpected did just happen, so now you get to, you know, speaking of Italy, it's actually pretty appropriate, but you get to watch. Actually, you don't get to watch, but you get to wait, as apparently I've just given the go-ahead to order a pizza, so here we go. I guess that's fitting for this game. So I need to actually place the order on this website. So what am I gonna get? Let's see what coupons they have right now, if any. That's weird, it doesn't look like they are, if not they normally do. Oh well, I guess well they have coupons pretty much every time, so I guess we're just gonna have to pay full price this one time. So let me see. Oh, what if I just assemble one? If I do this, the price is determined by how many ingredients I use. Let me see. What if I just have this basic four? Ground meat, ham, pepperoni, and chicken. And one more thing, we'll... Oh boy. And I forgot that, had the shuffle on for that, but apparently the pizza itself is going to be 212 pesos, that is, but let me see if I can get some. Or if I should just, I think that, oh wow, I think the price has gone up now. Oh, the pizza itself is then. Should be a large one. And apparently this is one of the pizzas where the crust is hollow and filled with cheese, or at least I'm hoping it is, since that's what it says on the order, so yeah. Uri has my has the address preset in, since this is hardly the first time, so send the order and 212. Alright. And the order has been placed. So let's see. Now we have to wait about 15 minutes for the pizza to arrive. Hopefully not much longer than that. So let me see if I can do some more game stuff before that happens. Apparently this though is one of the games that doesn't let me use the play pause key on my keyboard while it's running, so here we go. We still need to take care of that guy with the Tommy gun. Kind of trying to fake him out so he have to reload. And that is when your chance is pretty much. How many bullets does that take? Okay, there we go. Alright, beautiful. And we get his gun. And also the ones from the other guys that we shot.
You're dead anyway.
Oh boy.
I'll give you a face job.
Well, there's another guy. Apparently we took care of him though. Even though he wasn't armed. But I believe this is where Polly should be. Yep. Or not Polly,
Sam. Get up, Sam. It's over. He really went to work on you, buddy. Let's go.
It's nothing. You'll be all right. Doctor will put you back together again. You're tough as nails.
Apparently we didn't take care of that, guys. Well, as we thought so. But he really packs a punch. Shit. So, of course, now we get to... shoot him again.
That's it. I'll get you back in the car. Everything's okay.
Don't move, scumbag, or I'll fill you with holes.
But here comes our ultimate enemy.
You won't get past me.
Sure thing, buddy. Just stay cool. Everything's okay. Just go. No problem.
Just try it.
No. God. Go. Get him.
Apparently that guy has the dough, so... So now we get to chase him. And this constitutes the final part of the mission, but it's gonna take forever to actually do a chase in this car, since it's not particularly quick, but we will manage. I think, I'm actually fairly certain that his car is faster than mine, but... Well, let's see, I think it should be possible for me to shoot out the tires if I can get a good angle for that. Oh boy, or I could get in front of him. Do this. Also, I don't know what's going on with my mouse. I thought he would be bound to the window, but apparently it's not really bound that well. Since apparently it's doing stuff in the chat window. Honestly, I don't know. I've actually played this a bunch of times, so I've never quite understood just what the intended mechanics of this chase scene are, since it's never a particularly easy thing to get past. And then the music stops playing, which definitely adds to the mood, I think it'll be. And that guy's running into things, so this might be our chance to get up to him. Possibly, hopefully. Also, doesn't seem like we can shoot him since... Oh boy. Seems he actually needs to be to the left of us for us to be able to do that. Well, I know for a fact that if you let this chase go on for too long, you lose, but... Oh boy. I think we might be hosed because of that. Or not. But yeah, this, like I said, this scene has always been really puzzling to me. Since, you know, gunplay doesn't work that well. Trying to run ahead doesn't work that well. Flipping your car doesn't really work that well either. I think he's getting away. I think he might. No, just a hunch though. So I get to retry. Who knows how many times. At least now we know that it would probably be a better idea to try to stay on the right side of him. Or maybe if we push him up against the car, that doesn't work either. I'm not sure what's up with that. But I thought for sure that would have done something. Yep, hello, Hatcher. apparently joined the chat just in time. Well, joined in the sense that actually saying stuff since I'm pretty sure you've been lurking there for a while. If the email is going to go right, but yeah, hello. Just in time for this action-packed chase scene. This idyllic countryside. And I'm still not entirely sure what intended course of action is. I think you're actually able to run together once or not. They are, however, able to jump down here and ambush him that way. Nope. Bloody hell, really? No, apparently he doesn't even skip a beat when we do that. And we are quickly draining out our bullets without really doing that much to him. I think you might be getting away. I don't really see him anymore. Go that way? Yes, it did. Wonder if we can still get him though after all this. Something tells me that's not very likely. Oh, he got away. So let's try this one more time. I'm pretty sure we're supposed to, you know, if memory serves correctly, one way that. And we're supposed to trigger this is, like, being actually able to do anything against this guy. Actually be able to stop him is pretty much getting out of the car. That's how we get him out of the car. Not much we need to actually get him out of here, to corner him, which we thought I could be able to do there, but apparently not. Tunnel could be a good place for it. But I pretty much squandered my chance there. Hey, what are you doing? Come on. Yep, these speeds are something else from white. You know, I am reminded of the one scene from Attack of the Killer Tomatoes. Which, if anyone has ever seen that, I think they'll pretty much actually know what I'm talking about. But apart from that, well, let's just say that it evokes this to no small extent. Oh boy, well. That apparently the speeds are insane enough to make a skid like that. Or maybe our car is just too bulky. It has not enough center of gravity to... Yep, he got away. So let me see if I can try my tunnel strategy one more time. And actually get it to work this time with any luck. Oh boy. And I thought I might have a better chance of getting him there, but apparently not. Well, I know, I mean, there are some, believe it or not, there are actually some race cars in this game. We'll get to that section before too long, I'll bet, even though I've spent quite a while here. Well, I don't think my tunnel strategy is going to work that well. And I don't think it gives you an option to reload checkpoints from. from the menu or anything, so. So, yeah, I don't know how well this is going to be. I don't think you're supposed to be able to explode a car. And I'm pretty sure that would destroy the money anyway, which is what... You know what? Just try to do it. Just accept your fate. There's pretty much no point at this point. See, I'm pretty sure the first handful of times I tried to do this, I thought the idea was you had to shoot out the tires and such. Well, as far as I'm aware, there's no actual reliable way to do that. And doesn't really help that this guy pretty much sticks to the right side of the road. And we can't actually shoot him unless we're on the right side of him. Since we are on the driver's seat and all that. Well, I guess it could be a better try. I don't think this will work very well though. Especially when he's so far ahead. Tokyo Sonoya, you probably mean Caucasus. I'm actually not sure why, or what the relation between Caucasus and white people is supposed to be, but maybe that's... Where the term name comes from, I'm not sure what the logic behind that is. Oh boy, sure, I wish I could see where I was going. Then maybe I would be able to see what the situation was with that guy. Oh, and I chose the wrong thing. Hang on. Well, if we go this far, we can always do this for all the good that'll do. I'm just gonna try shooting after him some more. Not sure whether that will do anything about it. It's not like I have a lot of options left at this point. Oh, yeah, trying to drive on the grass doesn't exactly work in our favor. I have the feeling the pizza's gonna get here before I get to finish this. Oh. Good. You know what? Screw it, just accept your fate at this point. Yeah, I guess Harry didn't know about that. So was hardly anyone in the stream yesterday. Well, that was a thing. Alright, apparently we managed to get one of his tires flat. I'm actually not sure if that did anything. I'm just trying to be optimistic. Nope. Oh boy. We actually did know that he's still going. Not for a moment, though, but... Actually, shit, we might actually be doing something now. He just seems to be going a little bit slower than usual. Yeah, you could hear the high-pitched mewing, that's... kind of the new kitten, which apparently is named Chibi, was doing. Oh boy. Not sure if I'm doing anything, but yeah, I'm pretty sure... relentless gunshots are the way to go at this point. Yeah, I think my tampering with the wheel still managed to do something after all. Ah, there we go. Switch to a different compass route for that one. So are you gonna stop or what, guy? Yeah, we did get his tires flat. I'm not sure how he's still holding himself like that, but... not sure how we're missing his giant bald head, but... how is he still going if his tires are flat? Yeah, maybe he's just dead now and... no, probably not since he's actually steering. I was gonna say maybe he's just dead and, like, his foot's resting on the pedal. But yeah, it looks like we're actually getting his tires flat. We're actually able to catch up to him. A lot easier. This is kind of the end. I thought, what risk is relentless in his attempt to escape. I can see that pretty much all of his tires are... I guess that's supposed to be a... flat right now. One moment. Well, turns out I was right about the pizza getting here before I beat this. So now that I've spent all that time getting it, let's see if I can at least put an end to this. And I run out of ammo for two guns now. I seriously don't know how I'm missing this guy at this point. Can I use my Tommy gun? No, I cannot use my Tommy gun because... That's a two-handed weapon. And here we go. Well, it took this far, but he finally decided to get out of the car, so... So, here we go. Where is he? There he is.
That's regular routine. Wonder what the next job will be like.
So that was a mission. And now we get a timely intermission. While I munch on my pizza, I guess.
That's how I got into it. 1 minute a regular cabbie, the next a respected mafioso.
You were all right with killing people? Usually people have a problem with that.
You know, I ain't one of those people with a thirst for blood. I don't need violence in my life. And I don't look for trouble, but I also don't have any remorse. They wanted to outsmart us, so we had to outsmart them. No excuses. It was all the same to me. I wasn't interested in the fates of other people. Everybody said it was just business and that the family sticks together. It was different from living alone and nobody giving a damn about you. Suddenly you're respected by all the people you meet. Everybody knows you can help them, but you can also destroy their lives. And everybody tries to ingratiate themselves to you.
And what about the police? You just walked away, just like that, from a massacre. Didn't you have any problem with this?
You work for the police. You ought to know. You know, the Mafia runs the whole city. The Salieri family makes over 25 million bucks every year. The papers were full of it. But nobody saw nothing. If they wanted to stay alive. We paid off the bureaucrats $6,000 a month. Your bosses had liquor at trade price and got payouts for special jobs from both Salieri and Morello. Case closed, lack of evidence. Cops would even move shipments of drink for us. I guess you'd have heard something about that.
So what about your two friends?
Well, they were better off than you'd think. Salieri had a good doc for his boys, and it's not like he ever asked any questions. In a few weeks, they'd be healthy and back on the streets again. The only one who worried us was Morello. He wanted to be the big cheese, which Salieri couldn't let him do. Salieri had no intention of being in second place. You know, a person becomes a don because of his thirst for power, and he doesn't care about any other rules than his own. That's how it is, Detective. So he'd be his own boss, independent of the police, of the state, of anyone. That's why a person becomes a don. Salieri and Morello both wanted it all. They kept sparring with each other, but they both knew that if it all blew up, it would be hell. The big difference between them was in their methods. I heard a little story about Morello.
Oh boy. And now our introduction to this villain.
I'm sorry, sir.
You idiot!
I didn't mean it!
Do you know what you've done? Do you know how much that car cost?
I was driving slowly, Mr. Morello. I don't know how,
Do you mean to say that I crashed into your car?
No! Sir, I wanted... no, sir, I...
No! Faster! Get in my way!
So, yeah.
Salieri built his respect as a businessman. Everybody knew that they didn't need to fear him if they did what they should. They knew that if they needed something, they could come to Mr. Salieri. So Salieri made friends, often helped people with various problems, and expected the same in return. When somebody crossed him, they broke a cardinal rule, and everybody knew what would happen. Morello was just a mean bastard. He built his power through violence. Even his friends feared him. Most people just tried to avoid him.
Speaking of avoiding things.
Listen, Tommy, I have a delicate job for you. I don't know anyone else who could do it better than you. You're a good driver, and you have experience. Well, to make it simple, tomorrow all the best motors are going to race at the city track. And I bet on one kid who's been a favorite up until now. I helped him along in his career a little. I like fast cars, and I said to myself that I could make back a little on that investment. You understand? And then Ralphie starts saying that some European has come over, and his car is certain to win. Ralphie knows cars. He's real good with them. But otherwise, he's a complete moron. What, he couldn't have told me before I bet on the kid?
But still, what the hell is a guy God knows from where doing here? These are American races.
Me and the consigliere here were thinking about what to do. Because a lot of our boys have bet the same as me, and they certainly wouldn't be happy if they lost their dough. And how would that make me look? Like an old idiot. Tommy, I can't let that happen.
We thought with our consigliere about what to do with it. If something happens to him, that's no way. It won't be fair play. I won't enjoy my winning at all.
Ralph told me that he knows a guy who guards the racetrack garage. Tonight, you're gonna go there and take this European's car to a mechanic who knows his way around these machines. He'll take a look at theirs and maybe improve ours. As soon as he's finished working on it, you'll take it back. It's important that the car is back in its place before anybody catches on. And don't even think about crashing it or getting caught by the cops. Are we clear?
Yes, boss.
If you pull it off, you'll of course get a share of the winnings. Now go. Ralph will tell you where and how.
So yeah, for this next mission, speaking of, you know, fast cars in the last mission.
Not now, Tom. I got my hands full, huh?
Pretty much going to see how far, how far that can go with this one. But first we need to find Ralph. He should be back here.
Hey, Ralphie. You got some news about this job?
Sure, Tommy. You need to go to the city racetrack and borrow that motor there. My friend Bobby works there. You go around back there and along the way is the gatehouse. Tell Bobby that Ralph sent you and Bobby will take you to the car. It's already been agreed with him.
And then?
You just have to take it to the auto service of my friend Luca Bertoni. It's in Newark under the Giuliani Bridge. He'll take a look at it and tune it a little. And then you just take it back.
This should be easy enough.
But you gotta get it done before 1:15 a.m. when the guard changes so that nobody knows that somebody drove the motor in the night. There can't even be a scratch on it. And try to avoid the cops. They mustn't catch you.
And how'll I get there?
Tony to use a car to get to a car, which we will then take to a place, get some work done on it, and then return it to the place where we found it, and then we'll take the first car we used to go back.
Well, I got something new in. Ain't no big thing to swipe one. Watch. You just stick a piece of wire in here and twist it a little, and you get inside where you gotta join these two wires.
Yeah, it shouldn't be a problem. Thanks, Ralphie.
Now don't you go sparing the gas, Tom.
So this is apparently a short six home. Actually not sure what level of accuracy there is with the actual car names in this, since well, I haven't really looked up any of them beyond one, which is the one that we're gonna be stealing in this mission. Because it seemed like the most interesting one to me, but I wasn't able to find anything like it. But anyway, yes, we actually need to go to a place, and I just realized that I didn't need to go in this direction because the place we're trying to get to right now is in the southwest, it seems. Yeah, I didn't get to experience the Mogecko stream in its entirety since I only arrived when that was pretty far into the game. But apparently people enjoyed it. Much here until a work's quarter, that's what this place is called. But I don't believe we'll actually be doing any work like on site here until much later on. But apparently we're about to go off the map again. Also, I hadn't really seen that, but apparently we need to note how there's pretty much a time limit for all this. Need to finish this in 10 minutes, it seems. Which is just as well, since there's actually two parts to this mission, but I think I'll just do the first part tonight, since I've already gone over the 2-hour mark in streaming. And I want to get to the other Doctor Who thing that I have prepared for too long, so I'll finish this part and then take a break from the game. So here's the racing circuit. I wonder if an Ione can understand days. I see.
Evening. You must be Ralph's friend.
That's right.
Okay, we'll take your car.
So here we go. Seems easy enough.
Go in and over to the garage.
Well, I don't know how common, how many people in English-speaking places have to learn Greek, but well, at least where I went to high school, I think pretty much everyone who goes to high school here has to take a Greco-Latin etymologies class, which pretty much means that you have to learn some Greek and some Latin, and you definitely have to learn the Greek alphabet at least. So I believe this should be the place.
Okay, we're here, buddy. Come on, we haven't got a lot of time.
And sure enough, here it is.
Okay. Is that it?
Yeah, buddy, be real careful. There can't even be a scratch on it. And avoid the cops like the devil, because this car will be real obvious.
That's right.
In about half an hour, the second guard will come. So you gotta be back by then, buddy. And be real careful, that car goes fast. Maybe it's the fastest car in the world, who knows?
Sure, Bobby, no problem. I'll take care of it in a half hour.
So we have the fastest car in the world, or at least what would be considered the fastest car in the world in the 30s. So how fast does it go? It goes pretty fast. It definitely goes faster than pretty much every other car we've been going so far. But we can't really afford to damage it that much. But you know, this is supposed to be a racing car, no? So at least this should give us the muscle we need to get this mission done and the time limit. And I'm pretty sure we're gonna get some special kind of I guess gags that we can see during this. Also, I'm totally going the wrong way, just now realize this. Although we just got crushed into it, apparently that wasn't enough to erase the damage meter. Sure, we want to go to the northwest, much the same way that we've been going. Over the course of the game, which is going through the tunnel and then. Well, that was kind of an uncertain situation. But yeah, I do notice that, you know, since I guess RPG Maker is mostly a Japanese thing, so. So it's not really that surprising that all of those, or most of the competent games around me don't have that distinct Japan feel. And that most of its fandom can be found in Japan. Also, when we go on this bridge we can find some cops, but they're all busy because they're looking at that guy. But apparently standing on the edge of the bridge, so I'm just going right along without drawing any attention. Pretty sure Mogi has translated it. I think Odiro mentioned that, or someone mentioned that. Apparently it was a VG person thing. I know that VG person pretty much translates a whole bunch of RPG Maker stuff from Japanese. So I would be inclined to believe that it was a Japan thing.
Hey there! You're from Mr. Salieri, right? I'm Lucas Bertoni.
Hi, I'm Tom. They say you can take the bite out of this monster.
I reckon so.
Well, you'd better get moving. We only have 27 minutes left.
That ain't much time. We'll see what could be done. You can hang out a while.
So now we wait to... for Lucas here to be... done with the car. Well, I would pretty much say that I personally don't really get the appeal of a lot of the RPG Maker games that much. Or at least the ones that have a...
Hey, how's it going in there?
Just finished.
Try
you
to
go.
Use... Well, games like the one with the
but
Mobix,
you're gonna have to hurry. It ain't gonna run as well
called.
As when you first brought it in.
Midnight Puppeteer or something
Thanks.
Like that.
Mr. Salieri appreciates your work.
Sure,
and
give
also
my regards
what
to
I managed to see up
If
Morgan
he ever needs
Castle.
Anything again, I'd be glad to help out. I bet on the same driver as him.
And my problem with these games is pretty much that... A lot of them try to tell a story with RPG Maker and I don't know if that's like a thing that's lost in translation, but the way they do it, it's like the pacing, especially the giant walls of text, ends up being coming across rather ham-handed, pretty much. And taking up way more time than it should. Also, that guy's still on the bridge. I don't know what's to do with him, but he's letting us... Hello, slip right by. What's your mouse? What are you doing? I thought you were supposed to be bound to the window. And now we only have about 5 minutes, I believe, to be able to get this one back to... where we got it. But like right off the bat, I think there's only like a small handful of RPG Maker games that I thought were executed in an enjoyable manner. But those games being among them ill. Oth and Toilet in Wonderland. But I can't really think of that many more that I actually did enjoy that as a whole. Also, I noticed that apparently those Japanese RPG Maker games appear to have the trend of, you can even call it that, well, apparently having a room at the end with all the characters like that. Or at least the ones with the original artwork for sprite and for characters. Oh boy. Well, we did a bit of damage to the car, but apparently not enough that. Yeah, believe it or not, I actually haven't watched the off-stream yet. Seems I wasn't around for that. I hadn't started watching Mike back then. But I did play the game. That's pretty much my source of knowledge for it. And I did like it. But let's see, we should be pretty much there in the time zone and stuff. From... Oh, from. Apparently that's what that says. How are we supposed to... Do I need to open this up myself? Is that the idea? Oh boy, I have less than a minute left, but I'm right here, so... Hello. Oh boy, oh jeez. Well, I definitely don't want to lose now, so... Oh god. Restart car. Am I trying to put this in the wrong place? That... I think I might be. Yep, I totally overlooked that, but I'm here right now. No.
So you pulled it off, buddy. And the car isn't even scratched.
Thanks, Bobby. It really was the fastest car in the world.
Volata
sure
Elenica.
We're lucky you managed it. I bet on the Don's car, too.
It seems everybody did.
I bet on it. So did almost everybody in my neighborhood.
I figure the driver's pretty important, too.
Sure. Well, I won't keep you. Good night.
Take care, Bobby. Thanks for the help.
Well, Elenica is the Greek word for the Greek language. I know that much. So I think based on the, based on that, I think I get a pretty good idea of what that statement's supposed to be. But anyway, that was the first half of this mission done with. Just tamper with the race car and... get back pretty much. And the mission's not quite over yet, but I think I'm pretty much gonna leave the game off here. For now, when I do get back to the bar. Thankfully, it's actually quite close by, relatively speaking. And there aren't really that many cops around at night, which is kind of counterintuitive. You know, at least where I live, which is a big city, you do see... you generally see a lot more cops around at night than you see during the daytime. Which makes sense, but apparently that logic does not run in this city. Erne, Einai, Akiola, Dreuta? Not quite sure what that's supposed to mean. I guess the first word is supposed to be Bernd. Don't know that you would pronounce it Berne, though. We're back at the bar, so I guess we could watch the cutscene for the next part of this, so we can get an instant preview of what the other half of the mission is going to be. Can you guess? Well, we're going to see, but I'm not actually going to play the second part just
yet. Hey, Tommy.
Where is everybody?
They're all at the track. You're late.
I needed to get a little sleep after last night's job.
Sure. Hello? Yes? Sorry, just got in. Sure. That's for you, Tom.
Hello?
Frank here. Tom, you did well yesterday, but now we need your help again. Come over to the racing track right away. That guy who was supposed to win the race got his arm broken by some thug. Probably no coincidence. Anyway, you're gonna have to race.
But, Frank, I...
Tom, it's a half an hour before the race. So I don't have time to teach someone else how to drive. Christ, Tom, this concerns a big bag of money. I hope you understand that.
Yeah, okay. Frank...
So I expect to see you here at the track in a few minutes.
You don't look too excited.
That's because I ain't.
So yeah, during the second part of this mission, Tom is gonna have to race. But as I said, that's gonna be for later at least. It does save automatically, and it actually gives you the options of all of these different parts of the game that you can pretty much jump to any time, which is pretty neat, but... But for now, that's going to be the game. It has a car cyclopedia, by the way. Since apparently they did put quite a lot of effort into the car aspect. Also, apparently this is one of those games where couldn't think of any examples last time I did this, but... Or last time this occurred to me, but... Well, there are some games where pretty much every time you tell them to close, even if you follow correct procedure, they pretty much crash, and that's the only way they know how to close. Apparently this is one of those games, but oh well. So I'm going to do what I usually do, which is... I'm going to take a quick break, and I'm going to stop the stream during that break. And when I get back, we're all going to be moving to the livestream channel. Since, like I mentioned, there is a half of a Doctor Who story I prepared for tonight. That I'm actually looking pretty forward to, since... From my original viewing of the classic series, I think I recall this actually being my... Well, not sure how to put it. I wouldn't say without a doubt, but definitely a contender for one of my all-time favorite stories. So I will see you guys there once I return from the break. I will be getting more pizza in the meantime, I suppose. So we will get there.